Hey, good morning, guys. It's Mike Bowen, USAT Rules Ambassador for the Southeast Region, and glad to touch base with you once again. If you missed me last week, Happy New Year to you, and hope you're doing well on your New Year's resolutions. I was just listening to a podcast this morning while I was hanging out at Park Run at the University of West Florida. They were talking about resolutions and stuff like that. So I do want to touch base with you about New Year's resolutions, and not necessarily, hope you're getting along fine in yours, and hopefully not just the ones that I talked about a couple weeks previously, you know, about like checking your helmet and your wetsuit and your bike and reading through the USAT competition rules to make sure that you're all up to date and ready for next season, you know. But one of the resolutions that I hope that you'll take to heart, you know, from me, is I hope that you choose this year to be a more active member of the triathlon community. You know, get involved in your club or bring a new participant into the multi-sport world. You know, if you have a beginner's program at your club, get somebody involved in it. Get them out. Get involved in duathlon if it's a person who's not necessarily into swimming. If they don't particularly care for swimming and all you have is triathlon, then you know, maybe get them involved in a relay. You know, do the swim portion of a relay for them and let them do the bike and run. But that's, you know, a little bit of out of what I was wanting to talk about this, you know, this morning. But, you know, try to bring a new participant into multisport. You know, I find that the community is very welcoming and, you know, very open to people of all body types. You don't have to be lean and greyhound-like like the Brownlee brothers when you see these ITU guys racing and stuff like that. People that are plus size are definitely welcomed into triathlon, and people very welcoming regardless of how large or how small you are. All right, but a couple things I want to have you think about this year, and as far as resolutions, take the time to read the rules and make sure that you set the example during your training sessions. If you're out on the bike, make sure that every time that you get on your bicycle, when you throw your leg over the top tube, that you have that helmet on and secured. And that you're safely riding, and you're safe on the roads when you're running. This last week there was a runner who recently died in an accident on Bayshore Drive in Tampa. And if you know anything about Bayshore Drive, they have this very wide, 12-foot wide sidewalk along the seawall by Tampa Bay. And I'm not sure of the details on how the automobile, you know, came off and struck the runner. I mean, this was a gentleman who was out on a run, but got to keep your head out on a swivel when you're out there on the roads there, because, you know, cars hurt, as a friend of mine once said. Take time to think about fairness, you know, as you're, you know, when you're following the rules about fairness. Fairness is the foundation of the multi-sport community. If you haven't gone to the Clean Sport Collective, there's a website, cleansport.org. These are a number of world-class athletes who have pledged to, you know, to eliminate or to lessen the use of performance-enhancing drugs in sport, not just multi-sport, but also track and field and cycling and all these other competitive events. But go to cleansport.org and take a look and pledge to support brands that are dedicated to fair play and clean sport. Several of the larger apparel brands, I believe Hoka One is one, has, you know, signed this pledge. You know, but, you know, put your money where your mouth is. If you want to see clean athletes participating in triathlon and track and field and marathoning, then support the brands that are supporting athletes who are going to participate in sport cleanly and not using performance enhancing drugs. Lastly, you know, think about to resolve to try to give back to the triathlon community, perhaps as a member of the USAT National Officials Program, either as a competitive rules official, a CRO, which works the non-drafting races, or the National Technical Officials Program, which covers draft legal racing. There's a page for people who are interested in participating in the officials program on a USAT.org website. Especially important, if you've ever considered or thought about, you know, well, I'd like to go to the Olympics, Los Angeles Olympics are like just a little over 8 years away, and you have to have officials for all of these events to officiate. And well, in the United States, they're, you know, it's more likely that we're going to be using United States-based officials, ITU and USA Triathlon-based officials for the triathlon events. So I strongly encourage you, get involved with the National Officials Program. If you have any questions about the National Officials Program or life as a USAT official, please, you know, please don't hesitate to contact me at facebook.com/USAT rules guy, or you can shoot me an email at michael.s.bowen@gmail.com. This is going to be short, sweet, and to the point, and I hope you have a fantastic afternoon. All right, bye-bye.